Editing is likely to be the one aspect of your video or videos that you'll spend the most amount of time working on. You can easily feel it's taking forever to finish that one freaking video, let alone a number of them, or even worse, to consistently deliver one or two videos on a weekly basis every week without delay. It can literally drive you mad to the point of exhaustion. Does this sound familiar? I started my career over 20 years ago as a freelance editor doing TV commercials, music videos, and documentaries. And the one thing that I learned pretty quickly is that fast editing has got more to do with organization than creativity. You can't be creative if your workflow is a mess. Everything that I'm gonna tell you in this video applies to any editing software out there, whether it's Avid, FCP, Premiere Pro, Davinci Resolve, or even iMovie. Let's get right into it. The one thing that will make the biggest impact in your ability to edit fast is to make sure that you have no distractions. Get rid of anything around you that can distract you or ruin your workflow. Honestly, this is so important. Don't just put your phone on silent. The temptation will always be there to have a look every now and then. Turn it off and put it away somewhere where you literally can't reach it. Okay, maybe you don't need to be so extreme, but you get the point. Hide it if you have to, leave it in a different room or upside down in a corner on the table. If you work in a shared office or with people around you, consider using a noise cancellation headset. Whatever you need to do, you need to make sure that your attention and focus is on your edit. Nothing else exists other than toilet breaks. You do that, and I can guarantee you that you'll soon get into a zone where your concentration and focus will be so high that you won't even hear people around you, even if they're talking to you. You literally lose track of time, and that's when high productivity kicks in. If you're a filmmaker or a content creator and also edit your own videos, before you even get to the edit, use storyboards, a shot list, or a script to get organized. You don't need anything fancy. I mean, you can go fancy, of course, with a project management software or a video management platform like Notion if you work with a team. But a basic Word document with bullet points or a script for anything that needs to be said will probably do for most people. A shot list will help you list any B-roll shots that you need to film, but bottom line, you need to be precise. You don't just go out and improvise whatever you need to film. You need to know exactly what you need, why, and how it's gonna fit in your edit. Otherwise, you'll be filming all day with little to no purpose or direction. Storyboards are more suited to films and commercials than vlogs and YouTube videos, but essentially, you need to understand what needs to be done. You need to have your edit plan and structure in place before you film anything. You can then use that pre-production work you've done as a blueprint for your edit. Think of it as the architect's drawings. No building construction ever starts until detailed drawings have been approved. The same applies to editing. Plan before you start. Every aspect, every detail. It will save you so much time and improve your creativity when it comes to not only filming days, but also the editing grade. Much like anything in life, organization is key. This is probably the most underrated aspect in the editing process, but the one that, along with getting rid of any distractions, has the biggest impact on how fast you'll be able to edit. And the best thing is that it doesn't take much work to get this right. The secret here is to organize your footage in bins that are easy to find. Don't just dump all the footage in a single bin for you to shuffle through. Doing that will make it impossible to get any momentum going, because you'll spend more time trying to find a specific clip than actually editing. We all edit in different ways, and obviously it's not the same editing a vlog than to edit a film or a commercial, but the one thing that all of them share is good organization. Trust me on this, take some time to organize bins by day or by character or location, by camera used if you use several or different cameras or a combination of some of those. Sometimes you might need a clip or clips from a previous project, and you need to be able to quickly find them. If your filing is a mess, good luck trying to find anything later down the line. You need to make sure that you can easily find whatever footage you need whenever you need it, so you don't waste time looking for that shot that you know you have, but you just can't find. I also open a folder for sound and organize everything per source of audio. It's so easy to then drag and drop that whole main folder into my editing software, and all the footage will already be organized, and I can just get going. As you can see, organizing your footage with the editing in mind already pays off before you even get started. If I need to add graphics or additional sound, stock footage, music, whatever, I open different bins and sub-bins to keep everything super organized. It's the only way to locate the media that you need fast and will save you hours of wasted editing time. You need to do things in a certain order. For instance, do all the boring stuff first and then all the fun and creative bits once you've got all the boring stuff out of the way. And you don't just need to go over the top on the organization, just some common sense will do. In your timeline, don't just throw everything in whatever track you fancy. Let's say that you're editing a YouTube video. Look the way I do it. Track one has the A-roll or talking heads, and that's usually the boring stuff that takes the longest to edit it. Track two and three is for B-roll. You can use track three or four for titles and graphics and so on. You just build your timeline with different tracks for different aspects of your edit, so you can find and edit things easily. The same applies to audio. Keep it really organized. A-roll is in track one. If you have multiple people talking, each person and location has its own separate audio track. B-roll from one location in track two. If you have multiple locations, each location is on a different track, and so on. Organize your timeline and you'll not only be able to locate your footage quicker, but also edit faster and more organized. Every editing software out there will give you the option to assign or map out your keyboard shortcuts. This is huge, and if you're not doing this, you are wasting so much time. It will transform and speed your editing in ways you never imagined. You need to get used to this as soon as possible. Editing using keyboard shortcuts is way faster and also much more accurate than drag and drop. And don't just take my word for it. Look at this. Let's say I want to select in and out points for this clip and then get into my timeline. Have a look at how slow the process is if I use my mouse and then drag it to my timeline. Now see how much faster it is using keyboard shortcuts. Now multiply that by 1,000 or 2,000 edits that you might do per project, and you should start to realize how much time you waste. And not only that, but how much less accurate using the mouse for everything is. You can move so much quicker and accurately in your timeline using your keyboard. And when I switched to DaVinci Resolve, the first thing I did before I even started to do any editing was to map out the keyboard. It can take a little bit of time because there are so many different options that you can do. But if you want to get a head start, I'll leave in the description below a link so that you can download for free my keyboard shortcuts that you can then easily load up in your DaVinci Resolve. You can then easily edit and change them around to suit your style. But at least you got something to get started. If you were to do just one thing from what I suggest in this video, I would say that this would give you the most immediate improvement to your editing speed, without a doubt. Never edit at full res, whatever the resolution of your footage is. If you shot your footage at 4K, 6K or 8K, that's great, but do yourself a favor. Don't ever edit on a timeline at those high resolutions. It's literally pointless. You'll be wasting a lot of your computer's processing power, and you're never gonna see any benefit whatsoever. When you do an offline edit, you need to prioritize speed over quality. You don't want to edit at a rubbish resolution like 720p or less, if you can avoid it, but you don't need full res. Trust me, a 1080p timeline will be more than enough. Your computer will thank you for it, and you'll be able to edit with more tracks, more real-time playback, titles, effects, and so on. If your 1080p timeline is still lagging in performance, create optimized media for your footage or create proxies. Stick to a 1080p timeline. Do everything at that resolution and only relink to the full res footage when you're ready to output the final edit. You never do all your editing in the same timeline. Every day that you edit, duplicate your timeline and call it timeline 1, 2, 3, and so on. Every time you finish something and you're about to make any changes or experiment with some creative ideas, duplicate your timeline. Before you prepare your timeline for grading and you bring everything down to a single track, again, duplicate your timeline and keep a version of your previous timeline safe. You'll end up with 10, 15, 20, or even 50 timelines by the end of it, but the beauty of it is that you're not adding any additional media or storage that your computer has to handle. It's just a way to back up your editing as you go along, in case that you need to refer back to them. You can number them, organize them by date or by name, you decide. I find it easy to just number them, but if you work in a collaborative environment with two or more editors, doing it by date might be the better option. What this does is that if at any point you mess up, you delete something that you shouldn't, you realize that in doing something, you deleted something else. Whatever the issue, you simply go back to the previous timeline version and you can recover the clip, the scene, even the entire timeline if you made a massive cock-up. If you don't do this, and at some point you realize that you deleted something essential 30, 40 edits earlier, well, you're screwed. You need to undo everything you did and try to redo it again, which is never gonna look the same, let alone the time that you just wasted. And that is if you're able to go back enough to recover whatever it is that you deleted. Trust me, doing this will save you hours and at the same time will give you the confidence to try and experiment with whatever creative idea without having to worry about messing up your timeline. Let's imagine that you have your entire edit done and you now want to add background music throughout your entire project. At certain moments, you'll want the music to pop and then go down again. It could be between dialogue, introducing a new section, a graphic montage, much like when I do some of my videos and I introduce a new section with some graphics and titles and the music goes up for 2-3 seconds and then dips down. Normally when you do this, you produce keyframes. But unless you do this just a couple of times, a better way to do it is to cut where you want the audio to either go up or down. Set the correct level for the background music and the graphic section, and then add an audio cross dissolve for 8 or 10 frames. Imagine you have 15 or 20 pieces of music and you need to do keyframes for every section. It will drive you mad. Imagine that at some point you realize that the music is too loud or too low. You then have to go keyframe by keyframe adjusting to whatever new level you. Honestly, it's such a waste of time. This way, you can select all the other clips you want to change, and with 2 clicks, all of them are at the correct volume, and the cross dissolve will take care of bringing the audio smoothly up or down, or as fast or as slow as you want. This will help you claw back a lot of the time that you can then dedicate to being creative, rather than spending it in boring adjustments. And staying with audio, try not to add too many effects to individual clips and instead do it to entire audio tracks. This goes hand in hand with what I said earlier about being organized in your timeline. If you apply different effects to different clips, first you'll go mad keeping track of all of them because you'll probably have so many. Plus, a lot of the time, you'll be replicating effects, call it noise reduction, atmospherics, EQ, you name it. It's such a painfully slow and inefficient workflow. And for your computer, it's such a mess and so processor intensive. Instead, if you keep, let's say, the audio for a scene or a section in its own separate audio track, you'll apply however many effects you want to do only to that entire track, without having to go manually clip by clip. Now, if you're organized, I hope you can see how much quicker and organized your sound editing will be. On top of that, if you suddenly realize that you need to tweak, let's say, the noise reduction for a location or a scene, instead of having to go manually clip by clip, you just adjust it once for all the clips on that particular track, and you're done. This will save you so much time over manually adding or editing effects individually. As you can see, it's all about developing an efficient and practical way of editing. If you're organized, you can literally get more done in a couple of hours than someone else in a whole day. And you'll be working just as hard, it's just that you'll be doing it in a smart way. Make sure that your audio is in sync, because sometimes, despite the fact that editing programs can sync audio very easily, audio sometimes might be out of sync by a frame or two. Now, if you edit in an organized way, and for instance, audio from a certain camera or a certain day is slightly off, and you kept that audio separate in its own track, as I suggested earlier, it's very easy to select all the clips in that audio track, and in just 2 clicks, shift or rotate all of them, a couple of frames left or right, and everything is back in sync. If your audio is scattered all over the place, you'll waste an obscene amount of time trying to find them and then individually making the adjustments. That's just mad. As you can imagine, editing faster is not about doing one thing differently. It's about doing a lot of things in a simple and efficient way. At first, you might think it's a lot of work to do, but trust me on this, once you develop the habit, it will come as second nature and you won't even have to think about it. You'll just do it in autopilot. Your productivity will go through the roof, and you'll actually be able to spend more time doing the creative stuff and less time doing the boring technical crap that, to be honest with you, nobody likes doing. You know what? Let me give you 5 quick bonus tips. Don't keep rewatching your edit. At the same time, don't try to make each 30 seconds the best 30 seconds ever, because you literally never move forward. In your first cut, just spit it out, do the boring bits first, organize your timeline, don't rewatch anything. It's such a waste of time. In your second edit, remember, in a new duplicated timeline, start fine-tuning what you did before, adding the B-roll or interesting bits, and when you're happy with the scene or section, move on. Don't rewatch from the beginning. You already know if what you did looks good or not. Move on to the next section or scene, repeat the process, and then keep moving forward. Only color grade and do the sound editing at the very end, once you lock your final edit. Otherwise, you'll slow your system down because it has to play back several tracks of graded footage with potentially some graphics and effects. Leave all of that to the very end. When you get to the very end, bring all the footage down to a single track if possible. Get rid of all the unnecessary footage in your timeline. You don't need to have it there, you've already decided what's gonna make it to the final edit. It will also free up resources, so your system only has to play back a full res, a single track, rather than several layers of pointless footage. Consider using a music library, whether free or paid, so that you can quickly dip in and out looking for the right track for your edit. You do not want to be wasting time browsing online where to get music or sound effects. You want to have this ready so that you spend the least amount of time finding the right music or sound effect. But by the time you are adding music to your timeline, which is usually at the very end of your editing, you just don't have the patience for. Music and sound effects is something that you'll want to get done quickly, because by the time you get to this stage in the edit, your patience will probably be running very thin. Having a library of presets, ready-made graphics and animations, transitions, titles, sound effects, you name it, will save you a lot of time and hassle. A ready-to-drag-and-drop effect is infinitely much quicker than having to create it from scratch. How do you get these? Unfortunately, these are paid packs that you get online. There is no way around it. I've built my own library over time and I can't share them with you. It would be totally illegal. You'll have to invest in them over time, bit by bit, but they're relatively inexpensive compared to the time you save and how much better your videos will look, whether you do a corporate, a music video, fashion film, a vlog, whatever it is. Digital assets should be a must in your shopping list. Honestly, this is the fun part of editing, when you add creative elements to your edit. I'm actually thinking on doing some tutorial videos about this, so let me know in the comments below if this is something you'd like me to do. But the best part of all of this is that as you build your library of assets, you can organize them in power bins or favorite bins, depending on what editing software you use, and they'll be loaded automatically for every new project that you start, ready for you to use whenever you want, rather than having to manually import them every time you start a new project. I couldn't stress enough how important this is, because there will come a time when whatever standard effects, transitions, titles, and so on that your editing software comes with will not be enough to create the cool videos that you want. Anyhow, these are some of my tips or strategies for speeding up your editing. I know that some of these things might take some time to get used to or to implement into your workflow, especially if you've never done it before. But in the long term, you'll be saving days, if not weeks, in front of a computer pulling your hairs. Let me know in the comments below how you feel about these suggestions, and also whether you have any of your own. I always like to see how other people work and whether I can improve my own workflow with a new and different way of working. If you haven't subscribed to my channel already, feel free to do that and turn on the notifications so that you don't miss out on any of my upcoming videos. 2022 is going to be an epic year, and it would be really nice to share this journey with you. And if you have problems with wind noise in your audio and you don't know how to fix it, which is a very common issue, I have a video appearing just here where I show you how to fix most cases of wind noise. And I also have this other video appearing up here where I show you how to remove echo from your audio if that is a problem that you're facing. And with that being said, I hope you all have a great day, and I'll see you in the next video.